Welcome to our life lesson series, Immortal Voices, featuring 21 incredible stories from around the world and their immortal lessons. Today we are speaking on the first most beautiful word you ever heard. Only three men were ever born free. The rest of humanity were born as prisoners. Three men were born free, but of the three men born free, only one man lived and died free without seeing the prison house. Sin put the human soul in prison to Satan. Sinfulness is the true prison yard. Only three men were born without sin: Adam, Eve, and the Lord Jesus Christ. But only one of those, the Lord Jesus Christ, ever lived free and died free. The rest of humanity were born in the prison yards of sinfulness, sorrows, darkness, and death. To bring this home to our immediate lives, now think of a person whose parents were serial offenders and were all their lives sentenced to prison as slaves. And by the law of the land, all their children born in the prison house were born as lifetime prisoners to live in the prison yards all their days on earth. Now for that thing, if this were to be your life, how would life have been? Born a prisoner, living in the prison house all your days with all your siblings. Think again, how would life have been, and what would be the most beautiful word you would ever hear? It would be pardon. In other synonyms, forgiveness, freedom, liberty, salvation, etc., all meaning the same thing: to be set free. To the one in prison, to lifetime prisoners, the most beautiful word they will ever hear is pardon. The golden key to freedom, pardon, irrevocable pardon. The golden bridge between the prison cell and freedom. The one held behind bars, we have nothing appealing enough or satisfying enough at the sound of pardon. Leave them, let this go their ways. Lose him and let him go. No matter how high and strong our prison walls are, simple pardon dissolves them into ashes and powders for the free world to be visible and experienced. Pardon is the first most beautiful word we all ever had, and will be the most beautiful word to all lost souls. Friends, the little illustration above is the story of our lives. God created a free world, then created humanity free, but sin came in to put the world and humanity in bondage to darkness, sorrows, and death. Scripture says creation groans today even to be liberated. After sin came, everybody born into the world was born a prisoner, to live an entire life as prisoner to sin and Satan. That way, the free life created by God and the free world created by God will be a total stranger to humanity forever. Adam, Eve, were born without sin. The Lord Jesus Christ was born without sin. These men were born into the open fields of freedom. I am not Adam, nor Eve, nor the Lord Jesus Christ. Neither are you. We were born in sin, in the prison cell. Sin is a prison yard. All born in sin were born prisoners, to live all their lifetime in the prison yard of darkness and total separation from the God of life. Isaiah chapter 48 verse 8 said, "We were transgressors from the womb. We were prisoners from the womb, yoked as Satan's default children. For sin yoked the soul to Satan, as righteousness yoked the soul to God." Pardon makes a guilty man a free man. So simple a word, but so powerful in effect. Pardon is the first most beautiful word I ever heard from atoning Lord. Lose him and let him go. And for the first time, I tasted life, true life, everlasting life. What's your story? Freedom is not free, but the price is beyond man. So God gave it to man priceless and free. What a man cannot pay for all his life, he can only get it free. That's the story of our freedom. The cross of Jesus is the price of our freedom. The cross is deep. That's how freedom is deep. The details of the cross are endless. That's how the energies of freedom is endless. Freedom is a mystery. Mystery goes beyond unknown things to include anything that arouses curiosity and speculation. Freedom is a mystery to those who are in bondage. Freedom is a mystery understood by only people who are free. Freedom is the tongue tasting life, the airways breathing in life, our eyes beholding life and beholding it abundantly, our sound senses hearing the echoes of life. Freedom is life, everlasting life. One of the very renowned words in the Holy Bible is salvation. Salvation is freedom, pardon. Freedom is the first day of life. Freedom is the possession of an endless, borderless life. To be born again is to be born the second time. But this second time, to be born free. The first birth is bondage. The second birth, called born again, is to be born free, to be reborn into freedom, freeing the soul to engage God, to soar in God, to live in a world without walls. Freedom is a closed book to those who are bound, an unreadable chapter to those whose understanding are bound. No matter the brightness of the sun, the world will remain dark to those who cannot physically see. Freedom gives us eyes that see the sun of life, hearts that comprehend the open chapters of life, and a body that feels the gentle breeze of nature soothing to our body. Bondage kills the taste bud and makes life tasteless, nauseating, and regrettable. Ever seen a madman who could read and understand? Freedom loosens the mind, loosens the body, and frees the soul. Do all things possible to be free and stay free. The pathway to freedom is easy: embracing the Lord Jesus Christ, yielding daily to His Spirit, the Holy Spirit, filling our hearts daily with the Word of Life contained in holy writings of the Bible. This is the eternal roadmap to complete freedom: the Lord Jesus Christ. He is our pardon, and He is the first most beautiful word we will ever hear, and the last most beautiful word we will be hearing. Amen. Thank you. God bless you.